morning, everyone. Carol here at Oak House Journals. And obviously, I've got my planner in front of me. So I'm going to do my Margarete Miller Collage Weekly Planner assignment today. And I'm going to do assignment number 41. Just very quickly, if Margarete Miller's Collage Weekly Planner challenge is new to you, then all the information is in the description box below the video. We are at week or assignment 41, but that doesn't mean to say you can't start the assignments now if you want to. And I can honestly say that I started at the beginning of the year. I didn't think I would stay the course. It seemed a huge commitment, but I have enjoyed it so much that I can't wait to do my assignments each week. I might not be any good at them, but I thoroughly enjoy doing them. Anyway, enough of that. I'm going to get on and give you the prompts. So the first prompt is glass. So I've got an image here of a white wine glass printed out onto some tea-stained paper. Something triangular in shape. Well, I've got in here some faux stamp stickers, and I've got a couple there, a blue one and a brown one, that I thought I might use. Something found in the desert. I've actually got here a vintage stamp, and this has got images of cacti and palm leaves or palm trees on it, so those are going to hit this particular prompt. Library ephemera, such as a lending card, catalogue card or checkout receipt. Well, I've got a vintage catalogue card here that I'm going to use. Typewriter text. I've got this little note here. I thought this was lovely, beautiful paper, so I'm going to use that on my piece today. And as you can see, the bonus prompt is lined paper. And again, I've got some vintage lined paper here from an old notebook. Now, I'm going to work with the background, not only because it's got typewriter text on it, which actually hits one of the prompts, but because it is shaded pink and the lines on this lined paper are pink. So I thought that that would work pretty well on my piece. So the first thing I need to do is to cut out my wine glass, and then I can see where I want it to go on here. So I'll be back as soon as I've done that. So I've fussy cut my wine glass out, and I've left about half a millimetre, as close as I could get, to the actual black lines so that they will stand out and you can still see that I've got an edge to my glass. And the little half a millimetre edge of the coffee stained paper or tea stained paper is going to blend onto this piece. So I'm thinking that I'll probably have it positioned roughly central on my page like that. So I'm just going to put a dab of glue behind just to hold it in place for me. First thing I'm thinking is that I'm just going to take off the merest smidgen of this edge so that I can just get those pink lines showing. So I'm going to quickly do that. I think this is going to be too big on my piece, on my page rather, sorry. So I'm thinking I might need to trim it down a little bit. Let me pop that up there and see how that looks. And I don't like the circular hole I've got on the cabinet card. I'm just going to pop a paper clip on there to hold the cabinet card where I'm thinking I'd like it to go, somewhere like that on my piece. I'm going to try and hide that hole with my wine glass, which is easy enough to do, providing that's high enough. Something like that. I could even have it, yes, I like that. I was going to say I could even have it over to the left-hand side and still pick up that pink line. So let's try and anchor that underneath that paper clip up there. So I'm kind of thinking something along those lines. Let's see what I can do with this. And again, that can go under there. I'd like it to stagger off the edge of the lined background. It's looking very heavy. For me, my eye is automatically going to this piece. So I think I'm going to trim it. I've taken a little bit away. I probably will take a little bit more, but let's just see what this looks like. I want it to be far enough down so that it's covering the bottom of the lined paper and giving a little bit of interest there. And I want it to go over the top of the cabinet card. I'm actually quite liking having this there, and having the wine glass so that it looks like it's actually centered or grounded. Quite liking that actually. I've got a little bit of staggering going on there, not much. I've got a little bit of staggering going on here. Yeah, I'm liking that. And then I thought I could have the stamp there. I'm going to go with that. So I'm going to put some glue here. And I'm just going to glue my library card to the back here. And I'm just going to put the paper clip in to hold this in place, because it's going to be a tricky one to glue and to remember where I want it. Because I tend to find when I move these, unless I glue as I go, if I move them, then I never get them back in exactly the right spot. So I'm happy with how that's looking. So let's just glue this stem down and the base. There we go. Okay, now for my stamp. Now I thought that I would have this staggered in this corner here. So very simple collage this week. And I know you're probably thinking you've got everything on there, but you haven't got your triangular piece. So let me lift out this. So I'm going to go for another brown one and keep it very simple in terms of colours today, because I have an idea already where I want this stamp to go, or this sticker to go. And I chose this wine glass specifically because I wanted to do that. Now it does actually go over the side of my wine glass, but I'm not bothered about that. It was the best fit that I could get. Just hoping that it looks as I imagine it's going to look when I've taken it off. So it's one of these rub-on stickers as well, like a washi sticker. Love these. And there we go. So I could, if I wanted to, just pick away that little bit there that's overhanging, but I'm not going to. I'm going to leave it as it is, and I don't care that the stamp's upside down. I'm fine with that. And all I wanted was it to tie in with this stamp down here and be the same colour. So there we go, everybody. That's my piece for this week. I might go in with this little circular dot here and find a home for it. I'm actually wondering whether to put it down in that corner there. So let's have a look at that before I disappear off. And I like that on there like that. So I'm going to just put that piece on there. And again, very quickly rub it with my bone folder. And have that piece on there. So there we go, everybody. Couldn't resist putting that little piece on. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you like this piece. It came together pretty quickly. I did have a rough idea as soon as I thought of a wine glass and something triangular. The prompts, a glass. I've got my wine glass. Something triangular. Well, that's my wine in the glass. Something found in the desert. I've got my cacti and my palm trees. Library ephemera. That's my cabinet card. Typewriter text, that's my little note here, and bonus lined paper. That's my vintage sheet of lined paper behind. So as always, I will put some photos at the end of the video. You'll probably need them because of that sun shining through the window, but I hope you can just about make out the collage that I've done there. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. I'll see you in the next video. Take care now.